On March 27, 2022, at 6 p.m. local time, satellites detected a plume of ash rising from an unexpected volcano. Located to the north of the volcanic island of Iwo Jima, the so-called North Iwo Jima complex had not produced a confirmed eruption since 1945. This island itself did not produce the new eruption, but rather a submarine vent 5 kilometers to northwest of this irregularly shaped island. The volcanic cone the new eruption originated at is called Funka Asane, whose summit is located a mere 20 meters or 66 feet below sea level. As fresh magma interacted with adjacent seawater, it caused it to flash to steam, which generated a tall eruption plume. This plume rose to a height of 5,500 meters at first, but later became more energetic and rose to 7,000 meters above sea level. As the plume drifted to the northeast, small amounts of ash were detected, triggering a volcanic ash advisory to warn aircraft away from the area. This new eruption occurred in close proximity to the site of the largest explosive eruption in 2021, where the Fukutoku Okanoba volcano ejected 350 million tons of tephra, creating vast fields of pumice in the ocean which drifted all the way to Kagoshima, causing damage to several of its ports. So, is a similarly large explosive eruption imminent? This video will answer this question and discuss the ongoing eruption. The Kita Ioto volcano is located far south of the Japanese mainland, where it is 1,150 kilometers south of the city of Tokyo. This volcano exists due to a tectonic plate collision to the east where the Pacific plate is subducting underneath the Philippine Sea plate. The melted crust from this collision then migrates upwards, forming a chain of volcanoes. The island of North Iwo Jima represents the emergent summit of a primarily submarine stratovolcano which is primarily basaltic in composition. Its unusually steep slopes are owed in part due to the tens of thousands of years of erosion the landmass has experienced from rain, wind, and seawater. This island has not produced a single eruption in historic times, although there is an area on its eastern side which may contain a series of fumaroles due to what looks like hydrothermally altered rock. While this island is the tallest peak of the overall submarine complex, it is not the only notable vent. Looking at a topographic map of the seafloor, we can see a submarine plateau with at least 6 separate vents. These vents have each been the site of abundant submarine volcanic activity, constructing large underwater volcanic cones. Of these, only Funka Asane has ever produced an eruption in historic times. Its eruptions are characterized by a variation between relatively non-explosive submarine lava flows and moderately explosive Tsertsaean eruptions. Since none of its eruptions have ever been rated as higher than a 2 on the Volcanic Explosivity Index, a highly explosive eruption can be mostly ruled out. Thus, it is also unlikely that a large pumice raft will be created by this week's ongoing eruption. With this being said, I would stay at least 10 kilometers away from the erupting vent. Although satellite has yet to confirm any pumice rafts, this does not mean that there isn't any floating volcanic debris in the area. It is best to avoid the area as these volcanic rocks can heavily damage various boat parts. Although the ongoing eruption was the first in 77 years, it was not completely unexpected. Between 1953 and 2012, unconfirmed eruptions were reported on 17 occasions, but these all likely represented non-eruptive events during increased periods of submarine fumarole-related activity. Regardless, the occasional episodes of discolored water and bubbling of the surface indicated that this volcano was still quite very active. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Stan White for supporting this channel.